Hello, and welcome to another video. Today we're going to be stepping into the world of mobile networking, or connecting to the internet while you're on the go. Now, you might be thinking, well, I have a cell phone, it has internet access, so I should be set, right?
Do you guys not have phones?
Yeah, you guys all have phones, right?
And in most basic situations, yeah, that should be fine. Your phone's hotspot or tether feature can be really handy. But there comes a point when you need a device that's dedicated to providing the internet connection. Whether you're RV living, frequently traveling, live streaming on the go, or just don't have any traditional options available, there is a way for you to take your mobile internet experience to the next level. A way to get reliable and fast internet practically wherever you are. And this is where the star of today's video comes in. The InvisaGig 5G Cellular Internet System from Haven Technologies. So, what exactly is it? Well, it's a connectivity platform that uses the latest 5G technology to deliver speed and stability. It's designed to work with any Ethernet-capable hardware, providing a high-quality, user-friendly internet connection. Sort of like your typical home internet modem, this device would be the main point of internet access for all your connected devices. The InvisaGig features the Quectel RM520N GL modem and supports a wide range of cellular bands used by various carriers. And it also has carrier aggregation, which is awesome because it enables the device to combine different tower connections to increase its speed and stability. It's compact, rugged, and capable of speeds over 2 gigabits per second. Now, your actual speeds might vary, obviously, but this is the best way to ensure that you get the most out of your use case. That being said, let's get through the unboxing and setup of the InvisaGig. And here it is. Well, almost. I need to get it out of the box, but I figured I'd show you all how it's packaged for shipping. First, we have the packing list, which is going to let you know what should be inside the box. Mine just has the one InvisaGig unit. Now let's get the box open. Alright, nothing too crazy going on here, but definitely enough protection for shipping. Here's the actual retail packaging. I'll pull that out and put the box aside. Let's remove the plastic from this. Then slide the sleeve off. And once I figure out where I need to cut, I can open the packaging. Here it is opened up. Inside, we start with some literature. First, warranty information. And then a breakdown of the ports and connections on the device. Next, we have the InvisaGig unit itself. Then we have an Ethernet cable, a few stickers, and a SIM card adapter kit. This is a 12-volt DC power supply. And under here, we have four antennas. Now that we've got everything out of the box, let's take a closer look at the InvisaGig. The InvisaGig comes with four SMA connectors around the back, a mini SIM slot on the side, and on the front we have a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port and a 12 volt DC input jack. On top we have a nice little knock to a fan to keep it cool, and inside we have the Quectel RM520N GL modem. We'll grab the unit and the SIM card adapter kit. You'll also need a SIM card, provisioned for whatever cell service you use. Then we'll get the SIM card adapter kit out. It has different adapters for various SIM card form factors. Mine is a nano, so I'm going to use that one. Flip the adapter over, text side down, and set your SIM into the cutout contact side up. Then you'll grab the InvisaGig unit and flip it over. And insert the adapter, making sure to match the orientation with the image on the unit. And click it in. Next, you need to add the antennas. I'll pull these out and set them down. Grab the unit again and gently screw in the antennas. Be careful not to cross-thread these or otherwise damage the connections, as that could negatively affect performance. And then go ahead and rotate the antennas into position. We'll need to grab the Ethernet cable and the 12-volt power supply. Unwrap the Ethernet cable. Plug one end into the InvisaGig and the other end into a computer. Then unwrap the power supply. Plug the barrel jack end into the InvisaGig and the other end into a power outlet. At this point, the unit should start powering on. Open a web browser on the connected computer and go to the setup IP, which can be found on the bottom of the box. When the page loads, it should download a compressed folder. Open it and extract all the contents. The README file contains instructions for installing on various operating systems. At the moment, Windows users can just run the batch file, so I'll do that. This should open a new tab in your browser for the InvisaGig config utility. To log in, we need to type 3 and hit enter. We'll use the default password and hit enter. Now that we're logged in, let's go ahead and change the password. This is just done in the typical way. Give it the current password, and then a new password, and type the new password again. Once that's done, you'll have to log back in using your new password. Alright, now that we're back at the main menu, let's make sure that our SIM card is being read properly. We'll choose one for modem info. In here, you can see various information about the modem. But what we're specifically looking for right now is to make sure that our SIM card is being recognized. If you see a SIM CCID show up here, then you should be good. Use the Enter key to return back to the main menu. Next, we'll look at network mode. Here, we can select LTE, 5G, or both, and since I picked LTE and 5G, it'll ask if I want to enable or disable standalone or non-standalone. Now we'll set the carrier profile. You can allow the modem to determine the setting automatically, or you can set it manually. Under manual setup, you'll have options for generic, followed by various settings specific for different carriers. Once you've set this, you'll need to reboot the modem for the changes to take effect. To do that, go back to the main menu and use the reboot option. Once you trigger a reboot, the modem will, reboot and reconnect when it comes back. Once the device reconnects, we can log back in. And now we'll set the carrier APN settings. First, you'll choose between IPv4, IPv6, or both. And then you'll need to enter the APN for your service. This varies depending on carrier and what type of service you're using from that carrier. Once you've set the APN, you'll need to reboot the device again for the changes to take effect. After the device reconnects, you should see that it now has internet access. Let's check the modem info to make sure everything was set properly. Alright, looks like all the settings were applied properly, so we're done with the configuration. And there you have it. Now that it's set up and connected to the internet, it can act as the main access point for any Ethernet-capable devices. You can connect it to a router, a computer, an encoder, so on. It's an absolute game changer for anyone who needs a reliable, high-speed internet connection while they're on the go. Now, I want to make it really clear that I did get this device at a discount, but my opinions here are entirely genuine and not influenced by any kind of marketing material or some sort of script that they gave me. They didn't even really give me talking points. They just sent me the device and said, try it out and let us know what you think. I've been using it for my moto streams and it's been a smooth ride. An amazing upgrade from the cheap cellular modem I was using before. It's powerful yet compact enough to fit on a small pack and rugged enough to handle rough rides. If you're looking to move your mobile networking to the next level, this is it. By the way, you should follow me on Twitch. I live stream from my motorcycle as I'm riding around town. It's a lot of fun and it's something different to what you might have seen before. Now, if you're interested in getting your own InvisaGig 5G cellular internet system, you can look in the description box below for my affiliate link. It should go directly to the product page. And it is an affiliate link, so any purchases that are made on the website through that link, I get a small percentage on that, which is a great way for you to support the channel and get an amazing product at the same time. I really want to thank Haven Technologies for helping me upgrade my setup. They've been really cool and have been dealing with a lot of my emails. I also want to thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please leave a like and share it with someone who you think might benefit from it. That's going to be it for this video. Again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.